Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Being a Programmer. I am Rajashree, and today in today's video we can see HTML CSS practically. Theoretically we can see in previous videos, so link are provided in the description box. So in this video we see the practical of your HTML and CSS, how to add style sheets in HTML web page by using a CSS. There are three types: internal CSS, external CSS and inline CSS. All these three types are covered in this video. So let's start the video. First of all, open your Visual Studio, or you can also use in Notepad, but I use here editor VS Code. So in this VS Code I create a folder Bootstrap Practical, and in this folder I create a file by using this option, and I create here hello.html. okay, then I enter I rename here because there is a semicolon provided. So here you have to provide hello.html. okay, by using this file we can create a HTML document. So here is a hello.html. then in first line, in these two tags, I can provide here a doc type, that means document type of your HTML. okay, so this is the doc type. Then here is a file type which is HTML, and then your symbol. Then in next line we can provide a HTML tag which is the root element of your system, and then there is a head tag. Okay, so in this head tag you can provide, if you want to, some titles. Okay, I provide here a title tag. In that title tag I can provide some titles to this field. Okay, and title is a, this is, I provide here, this is the title page, this is the title page. Then your head section is also closed, and after that I start the body part. That means those elements which are specified in your HTML page without header are provided here, without title, without head section. So all this content are available in this body part. So here I provide here a h1 tag which is the header, first header of your system. So first header is, I provide here hello world. Okay, hello world, it is the first header. And after that I provide a paragraph. Okay, for that p tag is here, and in this p tag you can provide some paragraph. So I provide here, hi friends, welcome to Being a Programmer. Okay, this is the paragraph which is provided below the header file. Okay, and each and every tag which is open in your HTML, you have to close that tag. And after that your body tag is here closed, and then I provide here, first you can see our HTML tag is open, then here we can close that HTML tag. So this is the basic code or basic HTML file. I can save this file. Okay, and if you want to run this file, then you have to, if you want to, first of all we can see how to run, where from memory location where you can store the file. So first of all, here is the hello file. Okay, I open the Bootstrap practical folder, and then you can see here is a hello file. Then I right click on that file, then first of all select that file, then right click on that file, then you can see open with option is here. So click on that open with. You can open with this file Google Chrome. Okay, so just wait some moment, your Google Chrome will be open in front of you. There are multiple options: Firefox, Safari, or your Microsoft Edge. There are multiple options which are installed on your machine, that options, that browsers are available in that open with option. So wait, so you can see our head section title we provide here. This is the title page. Is this title page is of our web page title is provided here. So then here is the header or a header of your web page, which is here hello world, and then here is a paragraph. Hi friends, welcome to being a programmer. This paragraph is in front of you, but here is nothing, any styling. Okay, this is the first, this is our basic web page which is designed through HTML. There is no styling add to this web pages. Okay, to add styling you have to require CSS file. So there are three types to add CSS, which is inline CSS, internal CSS and external CSS. So look at here, I want to add this paragraph tag. There is a style sheet. Okay, so in this tag I provide here, this is a style sheet is required for only a single line. So I acquire here a style sheet through your CSS, which is inline CSS, and for inline CSS you can add the style sheet in your particular tag. Okay, so use style attribute. In the style attribute then provide equal to, and in the style attribute in double quotes you can provide your values. Okay, so in the style attribute you can provide the values. How, what are the values? So I want to color, and then provide colon, and which color is here? I want the black or blue color. Okay, I want the blue color, and then I provide here semicolon, and this is the inline CSS. That means single line CSS will be added here, or single line styling will be added here. So I add only a paragraph tag. There is a styling. Okay, so I click on save button, and then come back to my Chrome, and then only refresh your website. So you can see here is a paragraph which is in blue line. Okay, we can add the styling. So this is the inline CSS. But if you want to add internal CSS, if you want to add internal CSS, then in header tag you can add a style tag, not a style keyword. In this you can add a style tag. Okay, when you provide a style tag, then in that style tag, for which attribute you want to add, or which tag you want to add some styling, provide that tag here. I want to add h1 tag here. I provide here h1 is a selector, so you can add the style sheet to your h1 tag by using a internal CSS. So internal CSS can always add in a head section in between your style tag. So you can use a selector. So I can add the selector, which is selector means you can select particular element or particular tag what you want to add the style sheet. So I want to add h1 tag style sheet by using internal CSS, and after that you have to provide curly braces. And in that curly braces you can add your values or the name value pair. Okay, I want to add a color to h1 tag which is brown color. Okay, so heading will be in a brown color, and then I provide semicolon, and then I provide here a size. What is the size? I mention here a size which is suppose 12. Okay, and then we can save this program, and let's see what happened. We can refresh this. You can see hello world is in a size of 12, and then you can see it is in a brown color. Okay, this is the internal CSS. But now we can see how to use external CSS. So for external CSS you have to create a CSS file. So first of all I create a new file having name hello.css. Okay, then enter. So in this you can create a CSS file in any your editor. There is no compulsion. In this CSS file there are no HTML tags. You can only provide some attributes or some elements what you want to add the style sheet. So here I can add the style sheet to body part. Okay, I have to add the style sheet to body. Then I click here, and in double quote, in curly braces, I can provide the color, then background color. Okay, all these theme are here. So which the color I have to provide? So I have to provide a background color to body. Okay, so background color is I provide here aquamarine, and then save this file, and then I pass the path into your HTML file, because this is the external CSS. So here is externally you can create a CSS file, and then you have to provide a path into a HTML document. So where you can provide a path to your HTML page? So in head section, in you can add this link in a link tab, and in this link tab you can add your h reference. Okay, in this you have to provide a h reference attribute. So in this h reference, sorry, in this h reference you can provide your CSS file path. So you have to provide the name of your CSS file, hello.css, and then here is a style sheet I provide here. What is it? Here it is the style sheet. So in double quote you can provide a style sheet. So save this file and run this code. So you can see here is the background color of your body, which is aquamarine, and here is the brown color header, and here is the blue color paragraph. So we can see how to add internal CSS, inline CSS, external CSS into your HTML page, how to run this HTML code. So I hope this video is helpful for you. In this in the next video we can see how to install a bootstrap and how to add this bootstrap into a HTML document by using a CDN. So stay tuned for next video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Is the video helpful for you, please like to this video, also share with your friends, and do subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed. Also share with your friends, hit the bell icon for such new videos. If you hit the bell icon, then when I upload the next video you get the notification first and you never miss any updates of my channel. Watching for this video, thank you so much. And if there are any suggestions, there are any comments, there are any doubts, please let me know in the comment section. I'm waiting for your comments.